tell you what, Gamecock game today, bowl game day. Wisconsin versus South Carolina, 1 p.m., only 3 hours after we end our broadcast, will the Gamecocks take the field to play the Wisconsin Badgers? Badgers? You know, Gamecocks fight. Badgers, I don't know what Badgers do. You know what Badgers do? I tell you, we got a big Gamecock lineup for you. A big tailgating lineup for you this morning. And Cocky Talk says, hell yeah. Boom, kick them Badgers. Oh, no. I didn't know that happened. And he's not going to be drowning in beer today. He's going to be doing a bunch of push-ups for touchdowns is what he's going to be doing. And get Cocky out of jail. God. Well, I tell you, the Carolina Gamecocks. Steve Superior will be taking the field today, along with Jadavian Clowney. Slow the car down. Good God. You don't go 300, you go 70, 65, 55. Jadavian, come on. Well, you don't have enough money to pay the tickets. But you don't waste your money on tickets there, JD. Good Lord. Now, oh, Lord. The Carolina Gamecocks. If they hadn't lost to Tennessee, they may very well have played in the SEC Championship game and might have had a chance of beating Arkansas if it wasn't for, Auburn. Probably would have been a miracle play involved, you know. God. What's going on with them Auburn guys? They'll probably have a play today where, on the 6th that Florida State will actually just throw the ball to somebody in the end zone. The wrong end zone. I mean, let the other team beat you. Okay, well, we're going to do some skewers. We're going to do some stuff. Hopefully, it'll be kind of quick food for you. Tastes real good and help you with your tailgate. And this is something people could just grab up and go. And stand around and eat, and we're hoping it'll end up being something really, really good. So we're gonna jump right in here. Now I got myself a little bitty piece of a Boston butt. This is not a full Boston butt, but I think it's got enough pork on it to make us some good skewers. So I went ahead and got it, and let's see if we can. What we want to do here is we want to cut this thing up into nice pork squares that'll go on a wood skewer very easily. Now I have to pull out the big blue knife today. This son of a gun right here will cut something. Hopefully not my fingers. Now, the Carolina Gamecocks have got the Badgers in their way today. We need you to knock them out of the way. That's what we need you to do today. Connor Shaw's last game as a Gamecock. Oh, shoot, the bone is in there. Oh, heck. This ain't got much meat on it. It's got the bone end on it. I think we can get enough skewers off, though, to do a television show. If it had been the front part where there's no bones, but it'll get a lot more meat out of it. But what we're going to start off doing is cutting a slice off. Okay, then we're gonna cut this in half. That's gonna make a pretty nice skewer right there. Now we might have to go ahead and try the next slice. The bone's all the way at the bottom, at least on this one. So we're gonna. Oh, okay. There's a bone around here between Normandy and Western. We call this little boom, boom, boom. Yeah. Try to get us a skewer down the middle. I got plenty of skewers. I think it'll be a problem about getting skewers, having enough skewers. I just hate that bones in the middle. I'm not going to try to go around it and carve it out because I got to have pretty straight pieces, so I'm just going to try to cut over the top of it. Now, I could have got boneless, skinless pork, but it would have costed a whole lot of money per pound, so I didn't get it. I was trying to get out the cheapest way I could. The only thing I didn't realize is that the bone. We can still get enough skewers out of this right here. Slice this for skewers, man. I'm making a fairly big, depending on who's at your tailgate. Maybe they'll eat a big one, maybe they'll eat a little one. That's a big skewer right there. You know, I might leave that one. And that'll be just a mega mamma jamma right there. The great big mamma jamma. Okay. Yeah, I'll cut a couple chunks off this and we'll make a skewer made out of chunks. That is some pretty pork. Of course, the thinner and little you slice your pork, the more people you'd be able to feed. That's a pretty piece of meat right there. We got a piece of cartilage on, need to get that off of there. Okay, we'll cook this for Molly. Just throw it on there. All right, got our skewers set up. Now, what we're gonna do is, I'll put them on the wood sticks first. So we got our 100 bamboo skewers. So we'll still have that cardboard in there to give it rigidity. We can fold that back down when we get done. Let's get us some bamboos out here. Well, I think they're tough. They look like they might stick your hand too. Okay. Now we're going, whoa, what? Gonna come right up through the middle of this very long, big piece of meat. Now this is the mamma jamma, the mean, hell yeah, big one. This one here is for Ultimate Tailgaters BBQ. Hell yeah. They're down there in Orlando, Florida, having them a good time this weekend. Hell yeah. Kicking ass, taking names. By the time they get done tailgating, I'm sure they'll probably have the South Carolina Gamecocks winning by 21. Against the Badgers. I tell you, Wisconsin's always had a good team. They've always had big backs and big offensive lines. They've always plugged into big. Wisconsin has traditionally been the Cowboy State. Into some of these smaller pieces. Got to try to keep the skewer in the center of the meat so the meat will stay on there. If you got a real thin place in the meat, too much thin places, it'll fall off your stick in the middle of the cook. We've got some twists and turns that we're going to do on our cook today. Hopefully give you some ideas about what you can do on your tailgate, on your backyard cook, on your hell yeah. Bamboo makes that pork just line up there straight, don't it? Okay, here we go. Look at that big one. See, I'm getting hung up on some fat right there. Boy, fat just acts a whole lot different than meat. Meat's water-based, fat's oil-based. And now let's do our chunks. You could chunk it all and just do chunks. Did y'all think about that? All right. Now, we got all our skewers lined up here. Whoa, don't it look good? All right. Uh-oh, we got one more chunk. I really needed another chunk for this one. Boy, that's some nice looking pork right there.
That's a lot of work went into making that pork.
All right, gonna need them skewers in just a minute. So the next thing we wanna do is get our Junior Urias rub for grub. Man, we're gonna light these skewers up. Oh no, what? Let's go across the one side of them. That's what I call light them up. We're gonna turn them over. We're gonna go across the bottom side of them. Boy, that Junior Urias rub for grub smells good. All right, we're about halfway done. Now, you could use Buzz's butt dust on it. Buzz's butt dust would taste good too. All right, so we're gonna get, thick cut, boom. Thick cut bacon, man. We're getting ready to get crazy with it now. Bacon makes everything taste better. That's why it's $20 a pound now. Should have bought pork bellies 20 years ago. Because it's the bacon craze out there. And people still buy it. $20 a pound. All right, here we go. Now what we want to do is get one strip. It's supposed to be thick cut. I believe it's like extremely thin cut. I thought I could wrap one piece around. What in the world? I can't even get it apart. Shoot, I should have bought some of that butcher bacon at Save-A-Lot. I guess we're gonna have to skewer it to make it stay on there. I thought I could wrap it. Here we go. All right. That's a hell yeah. Hell yeah. Oh no. What you gonna do? Hell yeah. Oh no. What you gonna do? Ooh. Kind of hoping that once once we get this bacon cooking, it'll kind of freeze on there. You know, them skewers were really, really, really big. I guess we'll get into some of this smaller stuff. That bacon will wrap a lot further. Boy, this one's gonna be awesome. I mean, I want you to look at that thing. Now, if that ain't awesome, nothing is. That right there is too much. Matter of fact, might have to go the other direction with it too. Ooh. Oh wow. Could I get just a little skewer with that? Oh, how about a little bacon with that? Okay, let's put them three on the grill and get them cooking for you. And I'll keep wrapping these. Then we'll come back in just a minute, and I'm going to do a bratwurst like that. But we got a twist. We got something else we're getting ready to do with this. Oh, what? What? Oh no, look at there. We got this little gamecock fever going on today. Just a little bit. That thing's big. And that's all right. Oh. Uh-oh. We fixing to have a shish kebab fire up in here. Shoot, I'm gonna kill the air on it. Whoa. Well, we don't want to burn them. We just want to cook them. Well, I might have to give our Smoky Joe a failing grade on this one. I'm gonna have to go on over here to the, man. We ain't gonna burn our meat up. We're gonna try and cook our meat. We're gonna have to fire up the PG-500. Fire up our PG-500 while we're getting ready for the next round. Okay, we've got some bratwurst here. We're going to skewer them up. Go. I'm gonna skewer this one up. Get us a piece of our extremely fat Smithfield bacon. We'll have to see if our Weber Smokey Joe catches on fire with these on there. Of course, I think it was the bacon that was making it catch on fire. How about that Weber Smokey Joe, man? I guess we'll have to cook these skewers on offset. We won't be able to grill them. I guess we could put them in a pan, though. We'll go in there and get a great big pan. We can put them in that. Alright, let's put these on there. Let's see how they do. That Weber Smokey Joe might be just too hot for a skewer this morning. You know, that Weber Smokey Joe might be a little. That song gun's got some heat. See if he catch on fire. Yeah, they're gonna do the same thing. As soon as the fat from that bacon goes down in there, boom, we have to do it offset. Well, we'll just put it in the pan. Let's get us a little Southern Comfort blueberry juice to pour in here. I'm sure that won't take but a second to get hot. As that Smokey Joe is. To make it taste good. looks like that's gonna get to rolling pretty good here in a minute. I'm gonna let it get hotter before I put tinfoil on it. But you know, it's funny. I got Smithfield bacon, which had a high fat. Now I got Ingles brand cheaper bacon, and look at all that meat in there. It's a lot more leaner. How about that? You'd always think Smithfield would have leaner, better beef than the cheaper brand. The cheaper brand, I think, better bacon. How about that? All that meat in there, bacon. That's a big shish kebab. That's a lot of meat on there. You know, essentially, when we get done with these shish kebabs, one of them's gonna be a meal. That's the idea on Barbecue Superstars. I don't like the people to have to keep getting more and more and more. You know, you just got a little piece of nothing. You know, I want them to have enough where they go in there and grab it and eat it, they ate something. The best type of food to me is the type of food that you always end up having a little bit left because you couldn't eat it all. So that means you eat as much as you could. Oh, look at that. Pretty, isn't it? Pretty. Hey, that's better bacon. Make it a better wrap. I guess with all this fat on it, if I was going to use the Smoky Joe, I should have just put two on there and did it offset, put the coals on the opposite side of the shish kebab, and then that thing caught on fire immediately, didn't it? Now that's a nice looking shish kebab. It ain't got much pork on it as I want on the inside, but boy, it sure did wrap up nice, didn't it? Okay, in our last shish kebab, our last gamecock pork skewer, hell yeah, right here. That bacon will shrink up a lot, so will the pork as it cooks. Okay, we switched over to our PG-500. Got our shish kebabs in the PG-500. I guess what I really need to do is this flame's going by too. Come right up here. This is the hottest place of the grill that's not directly on the grill. Right above here. And let's put our skewers right up here on the top. let's let them cook for just a minute. And we'll work on our turkey legs. Try to get our turkey legs together. Turkey legs and turkey. Turkey wings. Huge. Turkey wings and turkey legs. Doggone turkey wings are so big, it's just hard to believe. I mean, I definitely want to cut them up today, though. And these things are going to take a couple hours to cook. They won't cook them. But two turkey wings are they're a pound apiece. A lot of meat right there. We're gonna put us some juicy red rough grub on it. Pan all this up. And we're going to put 5 strips of bacon in it. Bacon does make everything taste better. And a stick of butter. Gotta have butter on turkey. That much is for sure. I'm going to put it in our PG 500 in just a minute.
Be right back.
There's our stick of butter. Now we're gonna put tinfoil on it. Let's go ahead and bake it. That bacon juice will run down on there and make some outstanding flavor in the turkey wings. Now, a PG 500, we have a smoking side and a grilling side. Then we've got our skewers. Above the direct grilling side is the hottest place in the grill. Oh, yeah. Put this over on the smoking side. And we're going to try to. Get our skewers around without completely tearing them up. And so the skewer is going to take about 20 to 30 minutes. Got a whatever Smoky Mountain or a direct grilling something. We got our skewers cooking over here. Cook me a bratwurst right here, right quick, and then I'll demonstrate what the end is, the ending solution to all this is. Boy, that, whatever Smoky Joe is hot. Cook us a bratwurst right there in the corner right quick. Oh man, you gotta wonder, is it gonna catch the bratwurst on fire? Surely not. Well, one thing good about it is it's going to cook it fast, and I'll be able to demonstrate the last step. So, got everybody out there with their pork wrapped in bacon skewer. And then you got a little ending piece here that'll just make it just that much better. Look how fast that thing is cooking. Johnsonville looks good, don't it? I tell you, indirect heat might be the way to go. I'm cooking these skewers because that bacon can't take any direct grilling heat. So move all your coals to one side of your Weber grill or okay, let's get over here and get our skewer and we'll demonstrate. So just imagine if you got that big bacon skewer there. Bacon and pork skewer is done, looking good. Get out the cheese sauce. Oh Lord. Now, I tell you, a tall skinny cup like that, you can dip just about that whole skewer down in there, or a good end of it. Now I went and got some white cheese sauce. Man, white cheese? That is really, really, really good. Put that down in that glass. Oh my goodness. Now you can heat up the cheese sauce if you want. And we get our pork bacon skewer. Man, it ain't too bad with that bratwurst. Whoa. Let's dig all the way down in there. Mmm. Oh my goodness, now. You can't get cheddar. Can mix some salsa in it. Boy, I tell you, all those skewers will be done by 1 o'clock when the Gamecocks kick off. We're gonna get ready for the game. Oh my God! If you get your tall skinny glass, be smaller rounds, so take less, but you can still deep, dip deep. Pass them out. Let everybody have a glass of cheese. That's your cheese. Dip it. All right. Well, we hope you enjoy your tailgate today. We hope you have a good time. Get out there and cook you some skewers today. We want to say thanks for coming by on Barbecue Superstar. Scheduled day next Monday. All right, y'all have a good day.